Welcome to worship for this week of July 12th. I'm Dan Gutman, pastor of Zion Lutheran Church, and I'm so glad that you're here. As we gather together for worship, let's sing together our gathering song. God of unending surprises, this life is a tapestry of moments woven together, and we long to be weavers of love. Today we gather and pray that you would unravel our bias, unravel our assumptions, unravel whatever it is that keeps us from you. And as you do, clear space in our hearts for your word. We are listening, we are praying. Amen. Now a reading from Exodus chapters 5 and 7. Not long after, Moses and Aaron confronted Pharaoh. They said, "The Eternal, Israel's God, has a message for you. Release my people so that they may go and celebrate a feast in my honor in the desert." But Pharaoh replied, "And who is this God you call the Eternal One, that I should heed his message and release his people Israel? I do not know any God by that name. And furthermore, I do not intend to release Israel." The Eternal then continued his instructions to Moses and Aaron, saying, "When Pharaoh says, 'Do something wondrous to prove yourselves,' then Moses, tell Aaron, 'Take your staff and toss it at Pharaoh's feet, and it will be transformed into a snake.'" So Moses and Aaron went to Pharaoh and did exactly what the Eternal told them to do. Aaron threw his staff down before Pharaoh and his servants, and it was transformed into a snake. Pharaoh then sent for all the sages and sorcerers, and the most talented magicians in Egypt stepped up and performed the same act with their own incantations. Each magician threw down his staff, and each staff turned into a snake. But Aaron's staff devoured all the other staffs. And still, Pharaoh's heart was as hard as stone. He did not pay any attention to what Moses and Aaron said, just as the Eternal had predicted. God said to Moses, "Pharaoh's heart is as hard as stone. He refuses to release my people. Go visit him again in the morning when he is walking out to the water. Wait for him along the bank of the Nile and carry the staff which turned into a snake. Give Pharaoh my message. The Eternal One, the God of the Hebrews, has sent me to you. Release my people so that they may serve me in the desert. You have not paid any attention until now, but you will know that I am the Eternal by the next miracle I'm going to perform. I will strike the water of the Nile with this staff that is in my hand, and the water will be turned into blood. The fish in the Nile will die, and this river will be fouled with the rotting mess so that the Egyptians will no longer be able to drink from it. Give this instruction to Aaron. Take your staff in hand and raise it over all the waters of Egypt, over the rivers, canals, ponds, and lakes, so that the water will be turned into blood. Blood will appear throughout the land of Egypt, even in the water kept in wooden and stone vessels." Moses and Aaron did exactly as the Eternal had instructed. In full view of Pharaoh and all of his servants, Aaron raised his staff and struck the water in the Nile. When he did, all the water turned into blood. The fish that lived in the Nile began to die, and the river took on a foul smell. The Egyptians were no longer able to drink from it. The water turned blood was everywhere in the land of Egypt. But Pharaoh summoned the most talented magicians in Egypt who performed the same act with their own incantations. So Pharaoh's heart remained as hard as stone, and he paid no attention to Moses and Aaron, just as the Eternal had predicted. Then Pharaoh turned and went back to his house without giving this wondrous miracle a second thought. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. Today I want to share with you parts of a reflection written by a Presbyterian colleague, Stephen Fearing, on the artwork that was created based on this week's text. It's the image in our devotionals from the newsletter and the image that you see behind me. It's titled, "Anti-Creation Narrative," and was created by artist Lauren Wright Pittman. In a moment, the picture will appear on the screen, and I invite you to simply gaze at it if you're able. And as you do, I invite you to also clench your fist. Place it over your heart and keep it there as you hear these words by Stephen Fearing. There is Pharaoh, dressed in an opulent robe, a robe that probably costs more than most families in his empire make in a year. In his fury, he stands between the waves of water that will drown him and his army. Behind him, in concentric circles, are the byproducts of his greed, the plagues that haunt the nation as the tyrant's heart hardens. Frogs, flies, and locusts, boils and blood and hurling hail, all the destruction that rains down on the innocents as a tyrant digs in his heels. As the horror goes on all around him, Pharaoh clutches his hardened heart and stares resolutely ahead, his brow bent with belligerence. One of the things I love about the painting is its title. Lauren Wright Pittman cleverly named it Anti-Creation Narrative. You see, the biblical narrative begins in the book of Genesis with a beautiful creation narrative when God weaves together the earth in total perfection. First, God takes 3 days to create the world and then 3 days to populate it. In the first 3 days, God creates light, sky and water, land and seas and vegetation. Then God creates the sun, moon and stars, the fish, the birds, and then finally human beings. It's a beautiful utopia. But the second book of the Bible, Exodus, portrays Pharaoh as the very antithesis of God's creation. Pharaoh's greed literally begins to unravel the creation that God so lovingly made. The plagues are the deconstruction of God's intended order for the earth and its creatures and its people. And all this decreation, all of this destruction, all of this violence starts with one thing: a hardened heart. There are pharaohs all around us. But we can't afford to merely focus on the pharaohs that live out there. We must simultaneously attend to the pharaohs within us. How might we be called to soften our hearts to the needs of those around us? As Christians in this tumultuous time, as Christians who have sometimes chosen convenience over justice, we have a choice to make. We can soften our hearts or we can dig in our heels like Pharaoh. But a hardened heart can never be molded into the heart of God. Only a softened heart can be lovingly shaped into the image of Christ. Let us not lose heart when creation unravels around us because of the brokenness of this world. Rather, let us learn from today's story that it may never happen again. Let us practice our Christian faith together as a lifelong exercise in softening the hardened heart. Now I invite you to loosen your fist and keep your softened hand over your heart as we pray. O God, you have asked us to be like Moses, standing up for your people, standing up for justice, but too often we are more like Pharaoh, saying no to change and unraveling your vision for justice and peace. Forgive us for the harm we do to your planet and for the harm we do to your children. Help us to be like Moses. Forgive us when we're like Pharaoh, and soften our hearts to be molded in the image of your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen.
Take all I have in these hands and multiply, God, all that I am, and find my heart on the altar again. Set me on fire, set me on fire. Oh, take all I have in these hands and multiply, God, all that I am, and find my heart on the altar again. Set me on fire, well, set me on fire. Here I am, God, arms wide open, pouring out my life. In awe of your name, your mighty love stands strong to the end. You will fulfill your purpose for me. You won't forsake me, you will be with me. Here I am, God, arms wide open. Oh.
Here I am. Here I am, God, arms wide open. Pouring out my life, gracefully broken.
And now, called into unity with one another and the whole creation, let us pray for the world we share. Creating God, the mountains and hills burst into song, and the trees and fields clap their hands in praise. Empower us to sustainably use what you have given and to avoid overconsumption. Protect the air, water, and land from abuse and pollution. Unravel our apathy about climate change. Soften our hearts and help us meet the challenge of restoring your creation. Reigning God, we pray for our nation's leaders. Increase their desire for justice and equality for all people. Inspire authorities, judges, and politicians to act with wisdom and compassion. Unravel us and teach us to overcome fear with hope, meet hate with love, and welcome everyone as we would welcome you. Abiding God, care for all who are in need. We ask that you continue to bless with courage all in the world who are in treatment for COVID-19. Encourage and protect doctors, nurses, technicians, and all healthcare employees who work to care for them. For those who are worrying, provide release. For those who are struggling, ease burdens. For those in fear, give hope. Inspiring God, we pray for those in fields of science, that they have the spirit and determination to discover effective medical tests, treatments, and vaccines for all medical conditions. Help us to support their findings and abide by their recommendations for the safety of all. Unravel our resistance and help us make wise choices. Renewing God, revive your church in this place. Nourish the seeds you have planted that we might grow as disciples. Bless our efforts for online worship. Bless those who are unable to join us. Bless our congregational leaders as they make safe and proper decisions regarding Zion's plan of return. Unravel our impatience as we deal with the realities of this virus. Eternal God, we give thanks for the lives of all who have died. Comfort us in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection. Receive these prayers, O God, with sighs too deep for words, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always, and also with you. If you've been blessed by this ministry and feel moved to support Zion and its mission, to serve all God's creation in faith and love, then I invite you to go to our website now and click on the Give Online tab, where you can set up a one-time or recurring gift. Let us give our offering. Thank you. now may God, the great sower, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit collect our loose ends, hem us in before and behind, unravel our fear, stitch our wounds, and weave us together in love. Amen. Thanks so much for being here this week. I hope to see you again next week. Until then, go in peace. Serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.